Hello learners, welcome to our virtual learning class. Today we have what? Integrated science. We have integrated science and we are still under what? Forces and movement. Forces and movement. And today we are going to talk about effect of forces. Okay? Effect of forces. Now, in our previous lesson, we tried to explain what force is. Okay? The term force, or to understand the meaning of the term force. Okay, I also try to look at some types of forces. Okay, good. Today we are continuing to look at the effects of what? Forces. Good. So, in the previous lesson, we learned that force is a push or what? Pull on a body or on something. Okay, when you push something or you pull something, you are forcing the thing. So we want to look at the effect when you pull something or you push something. What is the effect of that pushing or that pulling on the something? Okay, that's what we are coming to talk about today. So number one, we have what? A force can move a stationary object. Good. A force can move what? A stationary object. Good. Now, this book is not moving. The table is not moving, so it's called a stationary object. I will learn that force is a push or pull on a body. So now, we said a force can move forward, a stationary object. So the book is at one place, not moving, so it's a stationary object. Okay? I'm not going to apply the force. Either push it or pull. Okay, let me push it. Now, good. We could see that the book started moving. Okay, now let me pull it to where I see. You see? Good, very good. Let's continue. So an example is what? If you push a book placed on a table, it starts what? Moving. Like you have demonstrated. Okay, so a force can move for a stationary object. It can make an object that is at one place to do what? To move. Okay? Good. When a ball is at one place, you kick the ball, you apply force. So you see that the ball starts moving. So now let's go to the next one. A force can speed up an object in motion. A force can help speed up an object in motion. Okay? For an example is when a football player hits a moving ball. The ball starts moving faster. Okay? The ball starts moving faster. Good. Okay, good. The ball starts moving faster. Okay? Good. Let's continue. So, for example, let's say this is my ball. Okay, though it's not moving. But let's say this. Now, let me put it, it's moving. So when I kick it, you see that it starts to move forward faster. Or even in the house, when you are playing football with your friends, okay? When they pass the ball to you, when your friend passes the ball to you, and the ball is rolling, is moving slowly, you can see that when you kick it, it moves with sort of speed, okay? It moves with speed. Good. So that is it. That is it, okay? Good. Very good. So that is an example of what? A force can speed up an object in motion. Or for example, if you are walking slowly and unfortunately your friend runs and push you, all of a sudden you see that the pushing will speed up your movement, okay? Your movement, okay? Or even let's say you are riding a bicycle and unfortunately, a car hits your back. You can see that you move it with a speed, okay? So, a force can speed up an object in motion. Good. Let's look at the next one, number three. You see what? A force can change the direction of an object in motion. A force can change the direction of an object in motion. Okay? Good. Now, let's see. I'm having a ball, a football. You see, when you kick the ball, you have directed the ball to move forward, okay? But when the ball hits a wall, the ball will bounce back to you, okay? So the force is like the wall pushes the ball back, okay? as we say that a force is pull, a push or pull on an object, okay? So when you kick the ball is spinning in your direction, but the when it sees the wall too pushes back on to you, okay? So that is how force can change the direction of what an object in motion or an object moving, okay? At the same time, you can be riding a bicycle, eh? And you can hit, it can hit something. So when it hits something, you can see that it balances, the bicycle did not balance, okay? So it will not go straight in the direction in which you are moving, okay? It will balance, good. Let's look at the next example. A force can stop a moving or object or slow it down. A force can do what? Stop a moving object or slow it down. Okay? A force can stop a moving object or slow it down. Good. You see, let's say you are riding a bicycle. Okay? You are riding a bicycle and your friend pulls the bicycle at your back. You see that? You are moving on speed, but when your friend pulls the bicycle at your back, see that you can't move forward with the speed again. So gradually you can see that gradually when you need apply more force, you see that gradually you come to what? Stop, okay? Or it will slow your movement. At the same time, when you are riding a bicycle at a high speed or top speed, and you apply what? The brake. You see that slowly the bicycle comes to do what? To stop. Very good. So it is what? A force that stop or the moving object or slow it down. Okay? Or slows it down. Good. Then the last effect is what? A force can change the shape of an object. A force can change the shape of what? An object. Good. Well, look at this book. It's like a rectangular form. I'm not going to apply force on it, okay? Now, look at it. Okay, I'm forcing the book. Okay, now you see that the shape is in a rectangular form. But now, when I look at it, I've changed it. It's now in a cylindrical form. Okay, now at the same time, let's look at this foam. Okay, or this duster. Now I'm applying force. Okay, you see, I've changed the shape. Okay, very good. So a force can change the shape of what? An object. Good. Very good. So far, we have learned about what? 5 effects of what? Of force on an object or on a body. Okay? Now let's look at what? Frictional force. Let's look at frictional force. Good. We learned in our previous lesson that frictional force is a force that acts at the contact of a surface when one body move over another hot body. Okay, very good. So it's a force which acts at the surface of contact when one body moves upon another hot body. When one body moves upon another body. For example, let's say I'm rubbing my palm together. Okay, there's a frictional force over there. Okay, now at the same time, you could see that it's not the hands will not move out faster like that. But when you apply out, well, you can see that it moves out faster because the palm have reduced the palm to have contact with each other, okay? But doing that reduced the friction, okay? Good. So now let's look at some uses of frictional force. Let's look at some uses of frictional force. You say it enables people to move about without falling. Good. As I'm working on, it's because of the contact my soul has with what? The ground. Okay? That enables me to move without falling. So as the soul of my soul has contact with the ground, there's what? A frictional force. Because we say it's a force that acts at the surface of contact when one body moves upon the other. So as I'm moving on the ground, my under the sole of my shoe have contact with the ground, okay? Thereby there's a frictional or producing a frictional force which helps me to move without falling. That is why when it rains or even when you unfortunately step on what? A banana peel, you see that if you're not lucky, you slip and what? Fall down. Very good. Because the banana peels prevent your the sole of your leg to have contact with what? Fresh air, the ground. Thereby reducing friction. Okay? That is why you fall down. Good. Now let's look at the next position for friction. For example, it enables or moving vehicles to stop when brake is hot. Applied. It enables or moving vehicles to stop when when brake is hot. Applied. Okay? When the car is moving and they apply the brake, you see that the brake will have a contact with what? The rim of the car. Okay? Okay, the brake will have the contact with the rim of the car, and this will reduce the speed. We really that force reduce of the slow down or stop a moving object. So when we apply this frictional force, it reduces the speed of the car. Good. Then we also have it helps to sharpen our tools. It helps to do what? To sharpen our tools. Okay. For example, our knife we use at home. The saw, those tools that we use to cut, okay, those tools we use for cutting, it's frictional force that help us to do what? To sharpen them, okay, when we send them for them to be sharpened, it's frictional force that help them to be sharpened. And the last uses is what? It prevents cars from slipping off the road, okay, the last one, frictional force prevents what? Cars from what? Slipping or skidding off the road, okay. It is not because of that force that hold the tire of the car together with all the ground. You see that when the car is moving, the car will just slip off the road, okay. That is why at times when it's raining or during raining and you are speeding, if you don't take time, your car will go slip off the road. Why? Because the rain on the floor prevents the sole of the tire to have contact with all with the ground. Thereby all, it reduces all friction. Therefore, there's less friction over there. So you see that the car will do all slip off the road. Okay, good. So today we talk about effects of all force or forces. I also talk about frictional force and all its uses. Okay, frictional force and its uses. Okay, I will urge you to do what? To revise your note to work. And in our next meeting, I will be asking you what? Questions about what we learned today, so that you'll be able to answer me well. Okay, good. So with this, we bring the lesson for today to what? An end. Have a nice day. Bye.